Yaskawa.
You're watching the IEC 61131 Basics video tutorial series covering functions and function blocks. Hi, I'm Matt Pelletier. Now, first, I'd like to show you the differences between functions and function blocks, and then I'd like to explain how bitwise functions work, how to duplicate and negate function inputs, and how to use the ENENO feature. Let's start with a comparison of functions versus function blocks. And I'm using an example here of AND and TION, two blocks that we've used. And the first distinction of an IEC 61131 function versus function block is that every single function will execute in one scan. One scan through the code and the inputs produce the output. This is not necessarily the case with a function block. Think of the block TON. Several scans are necessary just to tell how much time has gone by. And so because of this difference, you'll notice that a function does not have what we call an instance, which is this title above a function block. See, a function operates, and if there's another function next to it, it operates in the same way immediately. Whereas a function block has to store for the next scan through, has to store all of its operational results into memory somewhere, and that's called an instance. And so one telltale sign of is this a function or a function block is you look for this title. There has to be an instance of the function block. There will never be an instance of a function. Another property of the function is the single output. Every function will have just one output, and a function block may have only one or may have more than one. Moving down to the fourth, you must connect all output and all inputs for the function to compile. A function, you can't just leave any of the outputs or inputs disconnected. This is not the case in a function block. The code will compile if you don't connect outputs at all, if you don't connect inputs. There may be some inputs that are required for the function block to compile, and there may be inputs that are required for the function block to work. You won't even get a make to be successful with a function if you don't connect all inputs and the output. The next property of functions is that the output value depends only on the function inputs. This is the output right here, and its value depends only on the inputs. Think of a mathematical function. If you have several variables that determine the output, there's one right answer, and it depends only on those inputs. It doesn't depend on how much time has gone by. Think of TION. For example, we don't have an input for how much time has passed. That's a hidden, if you would, a given input that this function block will use in order to adjust its outputs. And other types of function blocks, for example, in PLC open, may control motion. Your motion may not be possible. You may get errors on the blocks depending on certain conditions other than the conditions given by the inputs to the block. So again, this is an important distinction. If you have certain values as an input to a function, you will always have the same output value. That is not necessarily true for a function block, because there are other factors that affect the outputs of a function block other than the inputs alone. Now, these last three properties apply more specifically to user-created functions or function blocks. Things to keep in mind if you're going to make your own function or function block. One is that if you make your own function, you can't put function blocks inside of it. If function blocks break all these above rules, how are you going to make a function out of function blocks? Can't be done. To make your own custom function block, you can use functions or function blocks in order to create your own function block. So you may ask yourself, why bother ever creating a customized function if there are all these limitations when you're creating a customized function? And one of the answers is that it's a very efficient way to calculate simple mathematical formulas. It's a very efficient use of the processor and RAM. If you were to make a function block to do what a function could have done, it will use slightly more processor power, slightly more RAM to do the same task. So if you can put it in a function, that's more efficient. If you have to do it in a function block, it's not so inefficient, but as the best practice, use a function if you can, otherwise use a function block. Finally, related to variables, when you create your own function in function block, you will not be allowed to use global variables to create a function. You can use global variables in your function blocks internally to make them run. However, it's not really a great idea to use global variables because then those global variables must exist in any future project in which you'd like to use your custom function block. So we'd recommend that if you have data you'd like to add to the function block, that you don't include a hidden input, so to speak, as a global variable that has to be created. Instead, make it as an input. And in another video, we'll be showing how to make a custom function and a custom function block. So you'll see how to do that. Now, when working with functions, some functions have what we call a bitwise operation, which means that given two inputs of the same data type and a block such as AND or, the bits of that data are ANDed. So it's more than the equivalent of two ladder contacts in series, because you're not limited with the AND or the OR function to using only Booleans. You can use any data type, and the data is ANDed with a bitwise result. As we see here, if input 1 had these values for each bit, and input 2 these other values, ANDing means ANDing together bit by bit, and that's how you get the result. And if you recall, when we created our array, I put in two array elements into an AND block and got the result. And the result was therefore calculated bit by bit of each of those word data types in the array. The IEC 61131 functions also have properties. Functions and function blocks have properties. And I'd like to focus on two of them, negate and duplicate. And we'll stick with our example here of AND. Negate puts this little circle, which is the same as a not, in front of it. It's taking the opposite of that input. In the case of a non-Boolean data type such as Word, it would negate every bit. So how do you get to the properties of a function or function block? You can either double-click or right-click and choose Object Properties. And this is giving the object properties for this block. And it lists here the inputs and outputs. And you can see in this table that we can negate an input. And then the other thing we can do in some functions is to duplicate. You do have to click on the correct one. Usually that's the bottom one. I can duplicate. So I could AND several of the same data type together by using duplicate, and I can negate inputs. So sometimes this helps to compact your code, make it a little more easy to understand. Instead of cascading ANDs together, you can put in as many inputs as you need. This technique also works with multiplication, and can put in an add, double click for the properties, and you could add several numbers by duplicating the input and add them all up together. And now you probably notice that when I add any function, it gives me this EN and ENO input and output. So what is that about? How can we use it? EN and ENO means enable and enable output. It allows you to enable or disable the execution of the function. Now, if you have the EN input, the enable input, disconnected, then you are automatically going to always enable execution. And that's why back here when we did this AND, I had said just don't connect it and it will work. So this is one option of not using EN and ENO if you don't want to, is that just don't connect it and the function will work fine. But the idea of using EN and ENO is that you can put then your block into a ladder rung and have different conditions either stop or start the execution of that function. And we can see here the output of ENO. Under most circumstances, that's equal to the input. So you don't really have to connect anything to ENO, but sometimes it's required. And one check is that if there's ever a function error, then your EN input may be on, but the ENO in output would be off. For example, dividing by zero or having some type of invalid error.
data. Some have misunderstood that the enable input, when disabled, would somehow clear the output or force the output of a function to zero. This is not the case. When the enable input is true, then the operation to calculate the output based on the inputs will occur. And every scan, the output will update. When the function is disabled, meaning en goes to false, then regardless of the value of the inputs, the output will remain as it was. So here I'm using the lt less than function. And at first, the answer was yes, value 1 is less than value 2. If at then and the next scan I were to disable enabling the function, and then at some point in the future, value 2 here were to change, since it's not executing the function, the output remains as it was. So the important conclusion is just to understand that enable means enabling the operation and enabling the output to update and disabling the output to update based on the inputs. That is EN and ENO. When you're creating your code, we understand that you may not want to use the EN-ENO feature. And so to avoid mistakenly connecting variables to that those terminals, you may want to simply remove the EN and ENO feature. And there's a couple ways to do that. One is a software option called Graphical Editor. You can, throughout your whole software and your whole project, just to remove the capability of functions with EN and ENO. And the other option is a worksheet. Per worksheet, you can remove the option of inserting blocks with EN and ENO. You also do save a few bytes of data and memory in your code. So if you're not going to use EN and ENO, we would recommend that you do insert them without it. And so let me show how to do that here. Let's look at it live and go to your project and do this along with me. We can go first to the objects menu. I'll do it this way. And I've got this block here, insert blocks with EN, ENO. Now if I take a new AND block, it inserts it and it's considerably smaller than it would be with EN and ENO. So that's one advantage. And it also has, as I mentioned, fewer bytes of memory when it compiles. However, I can go to another worksheet. Here I've got timers up and I could put an AND in this one. And you'll see that it does put in EN and ENO because the objects menu has this option checked for this worksheet. Back in the main POU, I had unchecked it and it remembers that. I can put it back and forth. And so this is an option for the worksheet. If you'd like a global setting, you can go to extras options. This has to do with the graphical editor. And you can uncheck this function with EN, ENO, and that will remove that for your entire project. Now, whichever way you do it, you do notice that the existing functions were not affected by that option. If you would like them to be updated, then you can right-click Update FBFU, and it will remove the EN, ENO input and thus reduce by a small amount your compiled code size. And this is what we're showing in this illustration of the presentation, is that whether you'd like to remove EN, ENO, or put an EN and ENO back in, you just right click on the function and your current setting will be applied to that function. So thank you. Hope that helps with functions and function blocks.